Uniform clustering technology provides a simple, flexible, and responsive messaging framework designed to scale to meet your needs. In this video, we'll be getting hands-on with uniform clusters by setting one up and going through the process of connecting a sample JMS application to it. But before we do that, if you'd like an overview on uniform clusters, you can watch this video and also head to the Uniform Cluster series linked in the description. Let's get started. To set up our uniform cluster, we'll be using the demo found in the Uniform Clusters repo linked in the description, created by our CTO, David Ware. For the purposes of this video, we'll be using the basic demo to quickly and easily set up a uniform cluster that we can connect our application to, but feel free to explore this further to learn more about uniform clustering. Clone the repo, then navigate to the demo directory and choose the demo that's best for your environment. I'll be using the one for Docker on M1 Mac. As you can see, I've got 6 terminals open in the relevant demo directory. 1 I'll be using to run the script to create our uniform cluster. 3 will be running a connection script that will allow me to monitor the app instances connected to each queue manager, and the N2 will be used to run the producers and the consumers. So I'm now going to create the uniform cluster by running the create Docker cluster script. This cluster contains 3 queue managers by default, and I can use the connection script to monitor each one. At the minute, we can see there are no producers or consumers connected to any of our queue managers. So let's add some. By running the producers and consumers script, we can connect 12 producing and consuming app instances to the uniform cluster. Initially, we can see the app instances connecting to any available queue manager in the uniform cluster. And as the queue managers negotiate hosting these app instances between them, they'll become more evenly distributed. We can see here there are now 4 producing application instances and 4 consuming application instances on each queue manager. So now that we've set up a uniform cluster and seen pre-compiled applications be balanced across it, let's take a look at how we can connect our own applications. For the sample program, we'll be using jms.get found in the MQ dev patterns repo. The application is a simple consumer and will get messages from a queue. You'll need to clone the repo, which is linked in the description, and follow the steps in the README in the JMS directory to build the samples. So now let's move on to the changes we need to make so that the JMS get program can connect to the uniform cluster. We first need to change our env.json file to allow our application to connect to any queue manager in the uniform cluster. Copy this block of code found in the tutorial linked in the description and replace what is currently in env.json with it. So what are we actually doing here? Well, by setting the queue manager attribute to star anyqm, we're saying we want our application to connect to this queue manager group initially, which is defined in the CCTT of this uniform cluster. Once the app is in the uniform cluster, it should connect to any queue manager that it is told to for rebalancing. If you're not familiar with the CCTT and queue manager groups, have a look at the article linked in the description. We've also specified that we want the application to consume messages from dev.queue.1, and have set the application name to be the same as the pre-compiled consuming app name from the demo, so it will be displayed as a consumer by the connections.sh script we ran earlier. We now need to open jmsget.java. So we know when an application is connected to a uniform cluster, it needs to be able to reconnect to different queue managers to facilitate balancing. To do this, we need to add this line, which says that the application should attempt to reconnect to a queue manager if it loses connection. Finally, the application needs to know the location of the CCDT so it can access the connection information for all the queue managers in the uniform cluster. And we'll do this when we actually run the application. So first, let's run just the pre-compiled producing applications so we can clearly see where our consuming application connects. Let's open a new terminal in our JMS directory in the dev patterns repo and run JMS get. It's at this point that we need to provide the location of the CCDT to the application as an environment property. So we'll use pwd to get our location, and we can paste that into the command that we get from the tutorial.
Looking at our terminals running the connection scripts, we can see that our JMS gets application has connected to QM1. So you can see we've now successfully connected our sample program to the uniform cluster in just 3 easy steps. Let's now connect several instances of this application so we can see them being rebalanced across the queue managers. To do this, we're going to be using this handy script which allows us to run 6 instances in one go. If you didn't use Maven to build the samples, you'll need to uncomment this line instead for the class path. You can also change what application is being run and how many instances are run, but I'll carry on with the default settings. Something to be aware of is that if we connected too many consuming application instances, we would see some applications disconnecting as their get operations timeout, because there wouldn't be enough messages on the queues for consumption. Before we run the script, we need to export the location of our CCDT using the same path we provided to our JMS get application. Let's now run the script like so, and we can see 6 additional consumers connected. After rebalancing across the uniform cluster, we can see that there are now 2 instances of JMS get on each queue manager.
Let's recap. We've been through the process of how to set up a uniform cluster and have connected several instances of sample JMS applications to it. Now let's cover the essential criteria that all applications connecting to a uniform cluster need to fulfil in order to be eligible for rebalancing. Firstly, your application has to use a CCDT, or a client connection definition table, to get its connection information. Doing so will allow it to dynamically get the information that it needs to connect to alternate queue managers during rebalancing. You also need to make sure your application is using a client mode connection, so it can connect to queue managers over TCP/IP using the connection information it gets from the CCDT. In client connection mode, the application doesn't need to be on the same system as the queue manager, so it's free to connect to any queue manager in the uniform cluster for rebalancing. As we saw earlier, we need to set our application to be reconnectable, so when it is disconnected from a queue manager during rebalancing, it will attempt to reconnect to another one instead of just remaining disconnected. You also need to make sure your application is using a version of the IBM MQ All Client that is 9.2.0 or later. For most use cases, this is all you need to know, but if you're planning on developing more sophisticated messaging apps that make use of multiple TCP sessions and connections, you'll need to optimize your app groupings and ShareConf values. For more information on ShareConf, head to the link in the description. And that's it. You now know how to set up a uniform cluster, how to connect a JMS application to it, and you know the essential criteria all applications need to fulfill to be eligible for rebalancing in a uniform cluster. For more information, explore the Uniform Cluster series, where you'll find this tutorial, articles, and a cheat sheet where we cover some common problems and how to solve them. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.